So hey, what if you dug a tunnel under the ocean? Wouldn't that be boring? Get it? You're boring a tunnel under the... well, never mind. It takes approximately 8 hours and 15 minutes to get from London to New York by plane. If you chose to take a trip by ship, you'll spend almost a week in the ocean. But what about traveling a distance of 3,460 miles within an hour? You'll find out how on earth this is possible after you hit subscribe and turn on notifications to stay with us on the bright side. The illusion created by transatlantic time machines, also known as supersonic planes, that bring people to New York 2 hours before they left London, will soon look like child's play. A new type of transportation might take their place. Futuristically fast trains that resemble transport capsules from sci-fi movies are supposed to move through low-pressure tunnels. Most of the air will be sucked out of these tunnels, and as a result, the speed of these trains can theoretically reach as much as 2,500 miles per hour. At first, this idea may sound completely unrealistic, but researchers from the USA and China are already working on this project. Some specialists are as optimistic as to predict the appearance of this new revolutionary type of transport in the next 10 years. Surprisingly, the idea of vacuum trains appeared about 100 years ago. American engineer Robert Goddard created several prototypes of a vacuum train that could connect the biggest American cities. Since then, a lot of designers have been working on the implementation of this idea. But the principle has remained unchanged. Construct a sealed tunnel, pump all the air out of it, and make transportation capsules hurtle through it. Wow, thinking about that just about makes me want to hurl. The tunnels can theoretically be built on or above ground, in rock, or even in the ocean floor. This last alternative, which might be possible thanks to large bore pipes, is the most interesting to us, but we'll talk about it a bit later. According to Ernest G. Frankel, shipping expert and professor emeritus from Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, such a vacuum tube may give us the advantage of high speeds. When you pump the air out of the tunnel, you decrease air resistance to the minimum. This leaves nothing to slow the train down. When an ordinary train moves through a tunnel, it has a wall of air in front of it. As it pushes this air out of the way, it spends its energy and loses speed. In addition, the movement of the train creates an area of low pressure behind it. This pulls the train back slightly. When the train speeds up, the air resistance shoots up. As a result, the train spends even more energy. The experiments Professor Frankel and his team conducted have proved that if you get rid of the air in the tunnel, you'll get rid of this issue. There must be huge pumps, approximately 30 miles apart, to help keep a near vacuum in the tunnel. The air leak would happen through the end stations. On its way, the train would pass through several airlocks. Each of them would reduce the air pressure more and more until the train started to move in the air-free tunnel. As soon as it reached this point, the capsule could develop its top speed. However, there's something that could make this type of transportation even faster. The combination of the vacuum train with another technology. For example, magnetic levitation. Now in this case, the capsule would levitate over a bed of magnets, and this would reduce the friction even more. While a simple train based on the magnetic levitation principle, such as maglev trains in Shanghai, can reach a speed of 361 miles per hour, in a vacuum tunnel, this speed could grow up to almost 2,500 miles per hour. But even if these state-of-the-art trains were brought to life in the next decade, the biggest problem still remains unsolved – how to build a tunnel under the ocean. Several ideas exist about how to create such a construction. Some specialists suggest drilling the ocean floor and making the tunnel there. Others believe that the only possible way is to construct a tunnel that floats in the water. If you went for the first option, you'd have to drill the rock of the ocean floor. But the Atlantic Ocean is incredibly deep, and its average depth reaches 12,000 feet. You can imagine how huge the water pressure is at the bottom. In most places, it reaches 380 atmospheres. If you dive to the bottom of a very deep swimming pool, your ears might hurt a bit due to the water pressure. Now, multiply this pressure 1,000 times, and you'll see what it is to work at the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean. Now, on top of that, you'd need a huge drill to get through the rock of the ocean floor. You'd also need to arrange a flawless drainage system. Otherwise, everything would get covered by thousands of tons of water. Luckily, there is a way to do this work with the help of special tunnel bores. These bores use hydraulic jacks to push forward special shields. At the same time, the construction crew immediately installs metal support rings and adds cement formations. To prevent water leaks, a special cryogenic technique that freezes everything ahead of the bore is used. When ordinary underwater tunnels are built, two tunnel bores start to work from different sides of the tunnel, meeting precisely in the middle. Unfortunately, these tunnel machines tend to fail a little bit too often. Even if they work flawlessly during the construction of a transatlantic tunnel, it would still take a whopping 111 years to finish the work. The other way to build the tunnel is to leave it floating in the water. On the positive side, you wouldn't have to dig through thousands of miles of hard rock. Thus, this would take much less time. This construction would be assembled directly in the water from separate preformed parts. But this method has a couple of disadvantages. According to Professor Frankel, there's a big technical hitch in this idea, and is connected with the warming tendencies in the North Atlantic. There is a possibility that icebergs would keep damaging the tube. You can imagine how terrifying the consequences could be. The constructors would have to consider how to protect the tunnel from all potential kinds of mechanical damage. On top of that, we shouldn't forget about strong underwater currents that may influence the tunnel. To avoid icebergs, this tunnel must be constructed at a depth of 500 to 700 feet below the ocean surface. But even in this case, constructors could run into deeper parts of the ocean where they wouldn't be able to anchor the tube to the bottom with tethers. There is an option of building a tunnel that would lie on the ocean floor. But this alternative doesn't eliminate all the problems of the tunnel construction, such as huge water pressure, big depths, and the difference of these depths. Besides, there's the issue of the unevenness of the ocean floor. An idea exists for how to solve this problem. Special ships with a load of gravel and sand could fill the cavities in such regions. However, if such areas are too vast, this method won't work. Moreover, gravel is often too heavy to be used. It might depress the soil or soft rock below. Whatever method of tunnel construction we choose, the biggest problem remains unsolved – the incredible cost of the tunnel. To build this underwater tube, constructors would need a huge number of complicated devices and incredible amounts of expensive materials. The most cutting-edge robots would be needed to protect the project from potential failures. The tunnel would need to be equipped with special seismic sensors to help the construction adapt to numerous underwater earthquakes. The total sum needed to finish the construction of the tunnel could hit $12 trillion. This is an astronomical amount of money. Unfortunately, our current technological development doesn't let us cut down on these costs. At the present moment, we can only dream of reaching the day when such a tunnel will become a reality. So, which method of transportation would you choose to travel from the USA to Europe? Plane, boat, or transatlantic tunnel? Hey, can't we just teleport there? Tell us about your choice and the reasons for it in the comment section below. Remember to give us a thumbs up, share this video with your friends, and hit the subscription button to join us on the bright side of life.